morning. Let me tell you how we got to this point. I was up at annual conference last week, about Friday, I think, and Leslie sent me a text and said, I can't be there this Sunday. She said, Jack is working somewhere and he has a hard time getting off, and he's able to get off that Sunday. We'd like to go to the beach. And I thought, well, she'll, you know, talk to Sherry. Well, Sherry's, we're cruising in Alaska, I think, so she's not around either. And so here's plan C. So you get plan C today. and before I forget it, this is a cucumber I brought up here so I wouldn't forget to tell this. Rocky Parker from his garden has some cucumbers, zucchini, and squash. Isn't that right? The three things, and they're back there in the container on the right. And so as you go out, you might want to pick some up because they look mighty good to me. So, and I'll put this one back. Okay. We'll start off with the call to worship. I'm actually going to use my Bible rather than the hymnal. She's got the hymnal there, though, but if you read the hymnal, my Bible is a New International Version, and it reads a little better, and it's understandable a little better, and so I'm going to read that instead of from the hymnal. So if you follow along the hymnal, the words won't be exactly the same, but they'll be close. Okay. Praise the Lord. How good it is to sing praises to our God. How pleasant and fitting to praise Him. The Lord builds up Jerusalem. He gathers the exiles of Israel. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He determines the number of the stars and calls them each by name. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. His understanding has no limit. The Lord sustains the humble, but casts the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make music to our God on the harp. He covers the sky with clouds. He supplies the earth with rain. He makes grass grow on the hills. He provides food for the cattle and for the young ravens when they call. His pleasure is not in the strength of the horse, nor his delight in the legs of a man. The Lord delights in those who fear him, who put their hope in his unfailing love. Extol the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he strengthens the bars of your gates and blesses your people within you. He grants peace to your borders and satisfies you with the finest of wheat. He sends his command to the earth. His word runs swiftly. He spreads the snow like wool, scatters the frost like ashes. He hurls down his hail like pebbles. Who can understand his icy blast? Who can withstand his icy blast? He sends his word and melts them. He stirs up his breezes and the waters flow. He has revealed his word to Jacob, his laws and decrees to Israel. He has done this for no other nation. They do not know his laws. Praise the Lord. Our first hymn this morning is Leaning on the Everlasting Arms, and that's on page 133 in our hymnal. All the songs come from the big hymnal this time, so we say hymnal, we're talking about the big hymnal. So Leaning on the Everlasting Arms.
Amen.
prayer is in bold, so that means we both say it. So I'll start us off and we'll have our opening prayer. Holy God, three in one, you are our eternal hope, our companion in life, our liberating power. Lead us in your mission, baptizing and teaching in your blessed name, so that all may worship you to the end of the age. Amen. And Jane will have our scripture.
Our scripture comes from the book of Colossians today, chapter 3, verses 12 through 17. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Well, this morning, I have the wonderful opportunity to introduce to you two young men who are going to praise God with music today and bless our hearts. We have Matthew Weaver and Clay Lunsford. And the first time that I met Matthew was at John Clutt's memorial service. Julie had wanted someone to sing. And when he got here and I heard him play, I thought, oh, wow. With music and with playing, sometimes God, in his wonderfulness, blesses people who are able to play. We call it by ear. My dad played that way in all of his family. In fact, the song we just sang, Daddy used to get on the piano on Sunday mornings, and he would play so beautifully while we were all still getting ready. And just a lot of wonderful gospel songs. So I'm not going to take any more time with this. I could talk all day about how great they are and how wonderful it is that God gave us music. It's wonderful that he has brought them our way today. I hope that he will share with you some of their experiences as they lead us in our worship service today. So let's all give them a Wesley Chapel welcome.
I feel Joe Carter family medley. This is sung every weekend on the Opry. You ready, Hoss?
It is no secret what God can do. about 65 years ago, he called it the good Holy Ghost, the good Holy Spirit. And I feel that here this morning in you people as I walked in the door and felt in this place. I'm glad to be here. Glad that I'm glad for America where we have this freedom. Can I get an amen right now? Oh man, you got one?
Well, we're in the same key. This is the Wings of a Dove. All the wings of the soul.
Yes, we will, and I won't elaborate too much time, but man,
sometimes we'll just cover everybody. But anyhow, she's from West Virginia. Let's just do the chorus.
Yes. Country roads take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, bound to mama's, take me home. Country roads,
and into the second verse. All my memories, they gather round her. My nerves, lady, stranger to blue water.
Yes.
Dark and dusty, painted on the sky. appreciate the warm invitation. We felt so welcome to come in this door. Thank you, Jane, for everything, and for our sound man back here. Thank you for everything. And Clay's going to get the banjo out. We're going to close out with some banjo picking tune. And thank you for inviting us to come today. And hopefully something we sang or what we spoke was a blessing to you and carry you through this week. And just think, 6 months today is Christmas. I knew that would wake you up.
Oh, I love it.
So, what would you like to do on some banjo?
You know, the patriotic tune, maybe?
Sure.
Let's see if I can get this.
How many veterans do we have in the church today? God bless you. Thank you for your service. Thank you. Hardly 4th of July is next week, a week away.
Well, let's keep talking just a minute.
I don't know what else to say, but I'm afraid.
Praise Jesus.
But you have a beautiful church here and have a warm spirit here.
That's close enough. You can hear that, can't you? Probably too much, okay?
You know how to tell when a banjo player is sitting level when he's got tobacco juice coming out of both sides of his mouth?
I'm glad to know that.
Let's do a fast picking before we get the patriotic one. Y'all want to hear just a little bit of mountain picking? And then we'll close out with a patriotic. Serious. We joke a lot. There's a lot of banjo jokes out there. Like, what's the difference between a Harley Davidson motorcycle and a banjo? You can tune a Harley Davidson motorcycle. But banjos are very hard to tune with the climate.
And we got it.
You got it?
Yeah, boy.
All right, Brent Andrews, patriotic banjo.
Made me think of three television shows.
Arthur Smith?
Which one?
Arthur Smith, one of them?
Well, it was one of them. That was one of them. Arthur Smith and the Cracker Jacks.
Yeah.
Kind of a local level. If you go a little higher than Porter Wagner, and you go a little higher yet than the Ed Sullivan Show. But y'all would be on any of those any day you wanted to be there. Thank you very much for being here, and we hope you can come back real soon.
Thank you.
Okay, this is a thing that Chris brought in that we are used to now, where if there's a situation or a person who needs prayer, then we call out their name, and after each one, then I say, Lord, in your mercy, and then we all say, hear our prayer. So, so at this time, if you've got a situation or a name of a person that needs to have prayer, then let's address those folks now.
The Lynn Harmon family.
Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah. I have a friend named Ted. It's just a matter of days and hospice.
Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
Hear our prayers.
Save the prevailing Harlem temple.
Lord, in your mercy. Lord, in your mercy.
Matthew and Clay.
Lord, in your mercy.
Bill,
Lord, in your mercy. Lord, in your mercy. Dear God, we ask that you help those who have been named to overcome their hard times. As always, we put our faith in you. Amen. Now we'll join together with the Lord's Prayer. It's on page 895 in the hymnal, if you wish to look at that. I happen to have, if I can find it here, what did I do with it here? I happen to have in my Bible a marker that my son made in, it says 1992, Vacation Bible School 1992. This was in Columbia, though, but on the other side, where he's decorated it and colored it up, it has the Lord's Prayer, and I still have it. So I use it as a marker in my Bible. So if you'll bow your heads, and we'll say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Okay, if you have a bulletin, there's a little message there, and if you don't have one, I'm going to read it out so that you'll hear this. It's time to share our tithes and offerings. And it says, if you would like to give a love offering for today's musicians, place it in a separate envelope marked Gospel Musicians, and it will be given directly to them. So be sure that you label it separately so that we know what goes where. So if you put something in a separate envelope and label it Gospel Musicians, then we'll be sure they get it before they leave.
Thank you.
Holy God, please accept our gifts freely given for the advancement of your kingdom. In your name we pray. Amen. Prayer of thanksgiving. Lord, teach us to offer you a heart of thanksgiving and praise in all of our daily experiences of life. As stated in 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through 18, be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks to all in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Jesus Christ. Amen. We have a final hymn today, "'Tis So Sweet to Trust in Jesus." It's on page 462 in your hymnals, 462. Benediction is a blessing spoken at the end of a worship service. And I'm going to use one that's called the priestly blessing, but you're going to know it as something else, and I know it as something else too. And it comes from Numbers, the 6th chapter, 22 through 26. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Tell Aaron and his sons, saying, this is how you are to bless the Israelites. Say to them, Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.